This woman is to be believed. You can believe Dr. Ford. This was attempted rape. And this is a woman who exhibits, Dr. Ford, courage, but the classic signs of post-traumatic stress.
I believe her. Listen, first of all, anybody who comes forward at this point to be prepared to testify in the United States Senate against someone who is being nominated to one of the most powerful positions in the United States government, that takes an extraordinary amount of courage.
Let me just say right at the outset, I believe Dr. Ford. I believe the survivor here. She has come forward courageously and bravely.
Well, she's come forward only to a newspaper reporter so far, although she did talk to her local congresswoman out in California. But there are a number of prominent Democrats who believe her, and that's why so many people want to hear from her on Monday morning. The deadline tomorrow at 10 o'clock, the Senate Judiciary Committee's got to hear from her, giving them the high sign. She'll be there.
All right, let's bring in Michelle Malkin. She's the host of Michelle Malkin Investigates on CRTV. Michelle, I'm sure you have a lot to say about this. What do you think about the double standard here? Because you're not hearing them come out against Keith Ellison.
Yeah, that's a great point, Ainsley. And there is a huge double standard in the selective belief by Democrats of certain women who lodge allegations of sexual assault or rape or sexual impropriety versus other women who do not fit their narrative. And there have been many GOP or conservative women who threatened the careers of lewd or lascivious Democrat men who have never gotten this kind of support. There's another very, very important point, and I certainly don't think that it gets enough exposure in these kinds of maelstroms in the media. And that is the fact that you have these idiotic Democrats who've turned off their brains for electoral and political gain in bashing men. And the one clip that you didn't play that has really been on my mind all week is this Senator Hirono telling men to shut up in this debate. Would she tell that to the innocent men and their families who've been falsely accused of these kinds of allegations, who've had to fight for 10 or 15 or 20 years in some cases to get out of jail because women lied? It is a commonality over time that people lie for all sorts of reasons. And to turn off your brain and say that there's no motive to lie when there are myriad motives to lie, whether it's for personal or financial or political gain, for revenge or anger, or vendetta, I mean, come on, people, this is insane. And to hijack the courtroom of public opinion, let alone courtrooms of law, by overturning what the burden of proof should be here, it is so dangerous. And where are all of the civil liberties advocates and people who believe in, you know, defending the rights of the accused, right, particularly of the falsely accused? Right. I just don't know what's happened to this world, guys.
Michelle, let's just use logic. This woman might be telling the truth, might not, but we don't even know her. We've never talked to her. It was 36 years ago. She tells us she doesn't remember everything, including the year, the place, the time, whose party it was. So just how could you actually go out there and say, I believe him? You don't even know him. And by the way, Senator Blumenthal violated the senator from Hawaii's declaration that all men should shut up. I believe he's a man and he spoke anyway. So I think he's going to get reprimanded. So in case you want a tiebreaker, I always look to Hollywood. Let's see how they feel.
Dear Professor Ford.
Dear Professor Ford.
Dear Professor Ford,
we want to thank you for publicly sharing your story of sexual violence.
As members of the Senate determine whether Supreme Court nominee Brett Kavanaugh
should serve as a Supreme Court Justice.
This context is critical.
The behavior you described was wrong.
Wrong, and runs directly counter to upholding the law and promoting justice.
He should not be confirmed.
He should not be confirmed.
He should not be confirmed.
They felt that way before this came out, but go ahead, Michelle, your thoughts?
Yeah, that's right. And remember that even before Brett Kavanaugh's name had been announced, that they were already opposing fill in the blank, stop fill in the blank. Okay,
right.
That ad that you just played, that's a cult. okay? These Hollywood liberal women belong to an unthinking cult. And I'll tell you, there's a huge cognitive dissonance because many of these Hollywood women are the ones who champion some of the people who have been exonerated over the last 20 years. 2,200 people, more than 2,200 people, many of them falsely accused by lying women of things even far worse than rape, murder. And yet there they are telling us we have to believe. I don't believe a gender. I believe evidence. And that is what we have to subject this woman to, this kind of process. And the fact that she doesn't want to speak after we let her speak. And now it's called bullying to ask her basic questions about her memory and recollection of something that I frankly believe never, ever happened. If people do not rise up against these kind of false allegations, it's their sons, their fathers, and their grandfathers who will be next. It could happen to you.
Right. And by the way, with Keith Ellison, you have a girlfriend, ex-girlfriend, and a son with witnesses and medical records, and he is the second most powerful person in the DNC.
Yes, Brian, this is the basic point here is, what is the evidence? What is the credibility? What were their contemporaneous accounts? When are these Hollywood women going to say, "Dear Juanita Broderick, I apologize. We apologize. Your allegations were credible. These are not."
Well, let's see what happens. Let's see. She, Dr. Ford, has the deadline of 10 o'clock tomorrow morning to tell them whether or not she will appear. And, of course, we would all love to hear her story. Michelle, thank you very
TikTok.
Much. You bet.
You
indeed.
Bet.